Don't understand if I walk with the limp.
That's exactly how it sounds. Hotness.
Aaron, I'm just trying to put the money in a chokehold, bro.
Okay. Does he say, come give me a hug if you're into getting drugged?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Beer and Friendship Show with your hosts, John Clouser and Aaron Naylor.
I really do feel like it. We could do a big old disco with that. Just the
big old disco
with the saxophone song.
That's not a disco. That's a sad song.
I know.
About, it's about such a sad never song. Dancing again with the love of your life.
Love of your life.
Because you those feet, your feet have got no rhythm.
Yep. Does your feet have rhythm, Aaron?
No.
No. No rhythm for you, Aaron?
No. No.
Why?
Lack of skill.
So it's just not lack of trying, just lack of...
Yeah. Is this a pep talk from coach? Like, you're not the best athlete out there, but at least give it a fucking shot. Try. Come on. You're better than that.
You're killing me, Smalls.
You're not, like... God didn't give you this talent, and I know it.
He did. Because
you suck at football. But, I seen you do pretty gosh darn good. In practice, you sweat your nuts off all the time. I see them dripping.
You're always the first one to the locker room.
Like I said, God did not gift you. You weren't even a gift to his mother. Your mother, she hated you. Trust me, I was around. But
and all she would do is just talk.
You're a gamer. You're a scrap heap. You're scrappy. You're like Scrappy Doo. Nobody likes you. You're Scrappy Doo. You ruin the football team. But damn it, you're going to go out there and try to kick the goddamn ball. That's all you're good for.
Aaron,
it's not my fault you weren't born with legs. What?
Can I be honest with you about something?
Please.
I have no idea what we're talking about.
I don't remember now.
I don't know.
It was some kind of weird...
Into wisdom.
Thingling. Thing-a-ling.
Thing-a-ling.
Thing-a-ling. Yeah,
that's a thing.
That's what we should have called the podcast.
Thing-a-ling.
Thing-a-ling show. It's just like a bunch. It's just a bunch of dicks hitting a microphone.
It's all news. Sorry about that, people.
It's like if you replaced the woman with a microphone and a bukkake. That would be a weird podcast. Like, some people will call our podcast weird, but then I'll tell them about my idea for Thingling show. And then they will hand me my food at Burger King and tell me to leave.
And Burger King.
I don't eat Burger King. I'm sorry for the false advertising.
Yeah, no one.
It was true advertising.
No one eats Burger King.
True advertising on Burger King. They are a place to get food at, but not me. I don't.
Why? Why not you?
They changed their chicken.
You don't like.
Also, I don't eat fast food very much. I try not to, but their chicken used to be super, super good. Like, it was kind of spicy, and it was completely different from McDonald's chicken. Now it's just like McDonald's chicken.
And you don't like McDonald's chicken?
It's all right. Burger King was always way better. And they used to have, like, Burger King used to have, like, shapes that their chickens were in.
Yeah.
Like, lightning bolts and stars and shit. And it's like a space. Chicken space.
Chicken space.
I wonder what chickens think when they look up. Like, man, can't comprehend this. I'm a chicken. This is hard.
Macaque?
Is it macaque? So, like, for stupid animals, I don't know the intelligence of a chicken. But honestly, it can't be very smart. They kind of get, like, they understand. My niece and nephew have chickens.
Yeah.
They have, my grandparents take care of, they have eggs. But they're dumber than shit. You know, they stay in a cage.
The eggs or the chicken?
Yeah, both. Well, the eggs are so stupid they can't even become real chickens. They eat them. But the chickens aren't very smart. Like, they'll defend their cage. Why? Who knows? But is a chicken, like, are dumb animals not too dumb to realize that they are dumb?
Hmm.
Maybe. I need to get down to the bottom of this. Maybe. I need to know the cognizance of stupid animals like cows, you know, or chickens. Like, do they just see us and think, like driving by, like, wow, I wish I could do that. Or just think, that's another animal. Like, they see you in a truck. Like, that's an animal.
It's an animal.
Everything's a fucking, like, a different thing that's not me. I don't know, I've always thought about how stupid animals think.
You've always thought that?
And then that makes me feel like a stupid animal. So,
because we're kind of like stupid animals. I just want
to be
animals.
Closer to the lessers, you know? I want to be like Mother Teresa, but not a huge cunt.
I thought she was a really nice lady. She's a
terrible person. We've talked about this before.
How? Wait, no, have we?
I'm sure, like, in the beginning.
Oh.
Very early on, I think.
Early
when
on.
When we were on religious tangents.
Mm.
Anti-religious tangents. Most of my religious tangents are just hating on Mother Teresa because she's a piece of shit. She was. God rest her soul. But, yeah, I want to know the plight, you know, of goats and cows and chickens. Farm animals, specifically. Like, cows are so stupid they can't even be wild.
Cows?
Yeah, they're all owned by something. If they're not, they're pretty much dead. You know what I mean? They're completely domesticated, even though they're not really pets.
Yeah.
Like, if they're, like, horses can be wild. Like, a wild stallion can, you just see a fucking horse. You're like, wow, that's a wild horse, unless it, you know, broke free. Which, in that case, it's a wild horse now.
Right.
But, like, if a cow breaks free, it's going back.
Mm-hmm.
Stupid animals. They don't have the brain space to get out of it. Where are you going? Oh, no. Oh, yeah, this is a good time to remind everybody that we don't have a guest tonight.
This is episode 48.
We did it. If you round up, that's 50. Yeah, we don't have a guest because I didn't want to talk to anybody.
Mets won.
Huh?
Mets won.
Yeah, I know. Okay. That's cool.
Go on. Sorry, go on with your... Sorry.
No, I'm done.
Oh.
I'm just like, I can't get off this for some reason.
Get off what?
The stupid animal thing.
Oh, the stupid animal thing.
I need to maybe write about it.
You should.
But it'll read like I just sounded. Like, just weird, like, everywhere, kind of.
I got a joke for you, I thought.
Go for it.
The Adam's apple is like the testicles of the throat.
Get out of my house. Get out of my apartment. Get out of my apartment. I was thinking about something the other day. I can't wait for the Antichrist to show up so that we can find out his birthday and have a new holiday. So it'll be cool to get a day off.
From work.
Like, you know, I don't know. Like, it can't be all that bad if the Antichrist shows up. Even though, like, we'd all be wrong about, you know, it all being a fun little story. Even though the Antichrist isn't that fun. But, like, I don't know, it wouldn't... Kevin McCondy! Hey, we're doing a podcast, Kevin.
Kevin McCondy.
Kevin
McCondy. You want to talk about that? You want to talk about how that's...
You want to talk about Kevin's fake identity?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Kevin gummy bears and beer.
Yeah, I think a lighter.
And a lighter. For the beer.
For
Kevin,
the beer.
You're the best person we know. Hands down, bar none.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Live, laugh, love ya.
I always hate every week I have to spend, like, the first, like, 20 minutes trying to find that, like,
just
that...
fiddling with it?
Yeah, find that perfect spot.
It's like a virgin trying to figure out what nipples do with, like, the first time they're with a girl.
Right.
Like, how's this...
It's like when
I try to figure out what nipples do with a girl.
Or don't you do a lot of things with nipples and girls?
Mine.
So.
They do Aaron, mine. Yeah.
How you been?
I've been alright. Been working a lot.
What's new with you?
Not much. I'm broke. Super broke. That made weird noises when it hit the floor. Just leave it there. Don't drop it again. We're going to have to restart. We can't restart the show.
I know, Aaron.
We can't do that to our fans.
But what's new with you?
Not much, really. It's been an uneventful time since the last casting. I've been working a lot. That's about it, really. Been watching the Royals.
What do you feel about them?
No, we're going to the World Series.
It's just we have to get over one.
We just gotta get over
the hump.
Yeah. We're all right. We're up 3-2, and we're going home. So we'll be fine.
You think we'll win it at home?
Yeah.
Well, I guess we have to kind of win it at home, don't we?
Yeah, we have to. If we blow this, that's gonna be pretty bad. That'll look really, really bad. Like, we're up 3-1. You know, the goal was to just get the one win in Toronto. If we could do that, then we were going to be fine.
If we could just get one win in Toronto.
We did. We got that one win. So, we're going back to Kansas City, and we're going to win on Friday with Ventura pitching.
Yay.
Which is scary.
Why?
Because he hasn't been doing very well.
You haven't been doing really well.
I have not.
Don't talk bad.
Well, if we go to Game 7, Cueto's going to start. And I don't know how that's going to work.
Oh, God.
He's been a shitbag.
God.
Other than that game he pitched against Houston, he has just sucked shit.
I think that's an understatement of what...
He sucked shit out of a butthole.
Okay, so did you watch game... Was it game 4 that we lost? No, we won game 3.
5. Oh, wait.
The one that we got blown out by when we had Cueto pitching?
Yeah, that was game 3. Yeah. Right. Yeah, the first one in Toronto.
Yeah. I think we could have won that game if we would have took Cueto out for that three-run home run.
Yeah, but... Well, we did, though.
No, we didn't.
We did. We took him out. We left him in for, what, two people, and then they both got on.
Yeah.
And then Medlin came in. But Medlin... He wasn't doing that great either. He gave up 2 home runs even after that inning.
Yeah, but that's all he gave up.
Yeah, but he gave up 4 runs. He didn't give up 4 runs. Cueto gave up one of those 4 after he left.
Yeah.
Or one of those 5.
But still, we ended up scoring 8 runs.
We were hitting that guy, Stroman. Yeah. We were hitting off him all night. We just couldn't get him in.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't hitting it far enough. We were getting home runs until Morales.
And then tonight, we only got one hit.
Well, we got two.
Yeah. Well, we didn't get one hit till we had one hit until the sixth inning.
But yeah, Salvi hit a home run tonight. That was really all that happened.
Yeah.
We kind of, sixth inning kind of fucked us. That sucks, but it's Toronto. Playing in Toronto, they're hard to beat. It's such a weird place to play.
Baseball.
It's like turf in a weird dome, and it's in Canada. That's the ultimate.
And it's full of Canadians.
That's the ultimate home field advantage, that you get your own country. That's crazy. Like your own country, basically almost the size of America.
Yeah, almost.
That's like everybody. Even if you don't like the baseball, you're gonna root for the Blue Jays.
Right.
That's fucking.
Just because they're in the playoffs.
Yeah, just because they're there. Shit, they haven't been in the playoffs since they won this World Series in, like, 93.
I was on
that
team.
We thought we had it bad. Well, we did have
it worse. We had it way worse, dude.
We had it a little 8 years longer than they did. Just 7 years. But, yeah, I'm excited. I think we're going to pull it out.
You think we're going to pull it out?
I don't see why we won't. We're going to be at home. We killed them at home the first 2 games. So even if we don't get, you know, game 6, I think we'll win game 7.
Right.
And then Cueto will buckle down because he's a good pitcher. Let's not forget he was one of the top 5 best pitchers in baseball for the last 4 years. Yeah. Until he came to Kansas City.
Isn't that kind of like the story of all those guys? Well,
that's the story of the difference between the National League and the American League. Because the National League, they don't hit. They don't hit as well. Like, all the big home run hitters play for bad teams.
Right.
It's a weird little thing. Like, you have to be an all-around kind of player to be, like, elite in the National League.
But I really hate
the American League just kills it. What's wrong with it?
There we go. I think there we go. I'm just trying to find that soft spot. There we go. I think we might have found it. Sorry, guys.
Sweet spot.
That's what that jiggling is for the last 15 minutes that you've been hearing.
Sweat spot. That's Kevin's back, everybody. Kevin is back to the podcast. He's been gone. He's been on a beer and friendship hiatus. The past, three episodes?
Yeah, he...
Oh, Kevin, we missed you so.
We were afraid we were going to lose him there for a minute.
We were afraid. I was terrified.
We were afraid, but...
At first, I was afraid. I was petrified. That's Aretha Franklin. But, Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
you. But...
Kevin's back.
Kevin's back, guys. And... Kevin's back!
Kevin's back! Kevin's back!
For you, Kevin. That was for you. We love you, man.
We made that.
We're glad you're back. We're glad you're back, bro.
Specifically for you. We made it off of YouTube for you. We stole it off of YouTube for you.
Yeah. Oh, but...
Sweet, sweet Kevin.
So everything's good with you? How is... Nothing's new? Just working?
Not really. Yeah. Nothing crazy? I gotta pay rent.
Gotta pay rent.
I'm fucking broke.
Gotta pay rent.
Orlando and Sacramento plowed me. Plowed me into the old ground. Money-wise. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Oh, God, John.
I can't handle that squeaking sound anymore. Sorry, I can't.
John's gotta get a new chair, because the IKEA chair that his mom bought... is a squeaking. Squeak. You need some WD-40. We've got some WD-40 under the sink.
Yeah, but I'm not going to waste my time doing that now.
This isn't a DIY podcast. This is
Oh my God.
This is a Chomedy podcast. You should have been using that chair the whole fucking time.
Oh my God, this is so much more uncomfortable.
I know, I understand you're a humble guy and you use that chair to be nice for the guests.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's your chair.
It is my chair.
We should kind of both be using these chairs just to kind of like pass it off as like we've got it under control.
Right.
You know.
Make the but talent feel uncomfortable. It is my fault
I broke that chair. The other one.
It's fine. So. Dude, do you not see how they're made?
Oh, poor. Yeah, well, do you see how I'm made? I'm doing pretty bad. Don't know if you noticed, I'm drinking Milwaukee's Best. Premium. Things are going great.
You say it like it's a bad thing, because that's what I drink every week on this podcast. Oh, and by the way, this week our sponsor is Milwaukee's Best Premium.
Thank you, State of Wisconsin. Your cheese curds and your beer are bar none, top 1,000 beer-wise. Cheese curds, top 2. Here's to you.
Here's to you guys.
Thanks, Brett Favre. Thank you, Green Bay.
All right. Okay. All right. Oh, man. So, I had something that I kind of wanted to talk about a little bit.
What's that, John? Did you have a subject?
Yes, I kind of had something I wanted to talk about. You know what today's date is, right?
Well, yeah.
You know what makes
October
today's...
October 21st.
Yeah, you know what makes today's date special?
I believe we're a month away from... a month and a half away from the Columbine anniversary. Is that what you were talking about?
No, Aaron. But
never forget.
That was my 9/11.
What's that? You were like, okay, so it happened in 99, so you were like 22. You were a spry, young old high schooler. I guess you're in middle school. What, your middle school?
Middle school. Was it happened 99?
Yeah, I think so.
So I was 10.
Okay, so yeah, you weren't in middle school. You were like 5th grade. Yeah. I was in 4th grade. 3rd grade. Because 9/11, I was in 5th grade. Man, all these tragedies are just running into each other like, step out of my way, you know? Memory. The old memory train's coming through and it's full of sadness.
But, no, actually today is the date that Marty McFly went back in the future and Back to the Future.
Oh, yeah. I love that movie.
Aren't you glad that we're here? We lived in a moment.
I'm glad that they were wrong about the Cubs winning the World Series.
They were close.
Man, I'd love to hear the, you know, for that dumbass shit to end. Fucking... They call it a curse. It's not a curse. Your teams aren't good. They're going to win the World Series in like 2 years. It's going to be the Astros against the Cubs. 2017. Calling it right now. Both those teams are fucking crazy good, but they're super young. Play it. Calling it now.
Aaron knows what's up.
They're both super talented teams. I hate the curse shit. With like the same goes with the Red Sox when they lost, like had that bullshit curse of the Bambino. They made the World Series a handful of times, but they lost to better teams. Sucks.
It does suck.
It's not like we were clamoring around as Royals fans, like, oh, we're cursed. We just were bad for a very long time. For like 20 like years.
Historically bad.
As soon as George Brett retired, we were like,
Well, that was fun.
This is how we start the process of rebuilding. It's going to take 30 years. And it only took 22. Can you believe it? I hate that shit. And what the stupid thing is that with that... When was... Back to the Future made 85, I think. I think it was 85. I want to say it's 85. So they did. They went 30 years into the future. The audacity to think that the worst team in Major League Baseball history is going to win the World Series against the Florida...
Florida.
It was like the Florida Crocodiles or some shit. They didn't have the name in the... Remember that scene where it showed it on like the hologram TV?
Oh, yeah.
And the Cubs with the same old stupid fucking logo they still have. The, like, three
Do you not
C's.
Like the Cubs?
I like the Cubs. I like the Cubs because they suck. I just said they're going to win the World Series in 2 years. They're super fucking good. They were not supposed to make the playoffs this year. But they were that good and talented that they did. But my favorite part of that is that... Like, Miami didn't even have a team. Florida didn't have a team in 85. The Devil Rays weren't around and the Marlins weren't around. So, that was eerily, like, almost a really good, you know, guess.
Yeah.
That they pulled out of their ass. Because the Marlins have won 2 championships since then, and the Rays have been to 1 World Series, but they both suck this year.
Which they do most years.
But my favorite thing is the Miami's emblem or logo, whatever, was like a crocodile with a baseball bat. It just looked like a shitty clip art thing, even though they didn't have clip art back then. Like, just draw a fucking, a crocodile, alligator, I don't know, just cartoony thing. Put it on a thing.
We got it. There we go.
They're going to lose anyway. Who cares? But... Yeah, we don't have hoverboards. We don't have flying cars. I guess we do have hoverboards.
No flying cars.
What else did back? Well, I guess. Yeah. So what else did Back to the Future have? Those movies confuse the shit out of me because I can't remember what happens in the movie, like where that what they do in the movie.
Wasn't there a train?
They go back in the past.
There's a train. There's a train. Oh, that was the third one. Was that the third?
Yeah, that was
one. No, there was a train. Wasn't there a train in the first one?
I don't think so. I think in the first one, it was mostly Marty trying to save his mom and dad being a couple.
Oh, yeah.
But the fucked up thing I've read about this is that as soon as he did that, it completely changed the whole timeline of his life. So when he went back 30 years to 1985, his parents were completely different. Biff was different. His sister was different. Everything was completely different except for the house he lived in and the girlfriend he had. somehow. I don't know how he still had the girlfriend. Like, everything was completely thrown off because he was there.
Yeah.
And that was kind of a, like, I like that being, like, a, like, going through the whole movie, and he's like, oh, I gotta save my parents, and they gotta love each other, so I exist, and all this shit. But having, you know, the mind to think, like, well, it's still gonna be different, because you're showing up.
Mm-hmm.
And it's completely different. Like, it changes his entire life as soon as he goes back. And he's like an 18-year-old who's lived this life, and now it's completely, every single thing is fucking different. That movie's crazy.
Now he's going to play, like, catch up the rest of his life.
Yeah, you get down to it. That movie's kind of sad. Like, that poor little guy. He's got to, like, adjust in the worst time of your life to adjust.
And that's what we wanted to talk to you guys about tonight was adjusting. Adjustments.
We like to talk to you about adjustments. No matter where you are in your life, you may be going through challenges, changes, John kicking the table.
Sorry.
Maybe your best friend doesn't show up to podcasts for a couple weeks.
Maybe.
Maybe you did acid for the first time. Adjustments. You know, you need... Sometimes adjustments are good. Sometimes adjustments are bad.
Real bad.
Like when the Germans were like, yeah, we'll...
We'll let Hitler rule us.
I like your stash, man. He's all like, thank you.
I like your stash.
Thank you.
I like your hair. We don't like your R as much.
Wear a hat on your face.
But...
I don't like your R as much. I said that way early on. That was some Austrians saying that.
And those were the first people he took out.
Hitler was Jewish. He just hated himself.
Himself. And he had mommy issues. He had a huge mommy issues.
And Oedipus complex. Where he wanted to fuck his mom.
Probably.
It's very Freudian.
Yeah. But.
So yeah,
that's what it was. That was for you, Kevin.
Kevin! Woo! Hey, so. Hey, Kevin, come and you wanna go home.
Hey. I don't know if they can tell. We're neither drunk or really
we're
into
not,
this one.
We're just having fun.
Just having fun.
We're just a handful of bros. Not a handful. Like a disfigured handful of bros. Three bros. Just three bros. That was easier to say than a weird handful of bros. We're just a handful of bros. Broing out with our toes out.
Dude.
Oh, shit. What?
We have...
Too much.
You close it really quickly. Why does your heart hurt?
Huh? It wasn't my heart. It was my the rest of me.
Well, Aaron.
Try to make it louder. Jesus Christ.
Relax. Did you see that there's a new update on iTunes?
iPhone. Yeah, I haven't downloaded it. Oh, on the iPhone? I think I downloaded it.
150 new emojis.
Oh, I didn't do that. Oh, no.
I did it.
All is lost.
You want to let's see what these emojis are.
I read somewhere that there's a middle finger.
Yes.
Why did I pick up Twitter? What the hell? There's a shit. I can't remember what it was now.
Let's look. Let's see. There's the taco.
Taco. Damn it! I think I. Shit! I need to get emojis again.
Yep. There's the middle finger. I'm doing a black middle finger. Perfect. I just texted that to someone.
Your mother.
I should have. There's clothes.
Be like, I'm sitting on this tonight.
There's clothes.
I like how you're like, oh, did you see this new Apple update? I was like, oh yeah, the phone? No. The emojis. Like, really? That's what you want to talk about?
Yeah, that's one of the things I wanted to talk about, you ass. fuck yourself.
Oh, that's hilarious. I thought you were going to talk about the Apple update. The phone, the thing update.
There's a burrito in a taco.
We made it.
We made it.
It's such a great time to be alive. God. Emojis rule the world. I bet Obama's got emojis. Because his shitty daughters have emojis. Did you read that one of his daughters got caught playing beer pong?
Really? Is that a bad thing?
I don't know. I don't know how old she is. She's probably like that age where you start.
How old is
15
she?
15 or 16?
Google it. See how old the girls are.
What if she's like 11?
One of them's pretty tall. I don't think she's 11.
Well, fucking Michelle's pretty tall. Barack's like, what, 6'1"?
Yeah.
Probably.
But I think one of them's like nearly 18. I think one of them's almost legal. I think she can almost do porn. So we're good. We're getting there. Dude, how fucked up would that be?
That'd be very strange. It's like Rudy Huxtable doing porn. Cosby's fake daughter.
Oh, yeah.
Now, looking back, it's not so weird.
I watched one of her videos. She just gets banged in the butt. That's all she does.
Really?
Just,
is that it?
She just gets banged in the butt a bunch.
I knew you would have watched it.
She's black.
I know. That's why I said I knew you would have watched it. Exclusive. Malia. That's her name. Malia? I don't know. The only cool Obama plays beer pong during college visit. The only cool Obama. That's hilarious. What is this? Like a fucking conservative thing? She's 17.
Okay.
Okay.
I said she was.
She stayed with a friend in a dorm room, and even though there were Secret Service all over the place, she still managed to party her ass off like she was a 2005 Bush twin. Yeah, this is this is called thedailycaller.com. It's got to be some kind of conservative.
The Daily Caller.
Caller, yeah, thedailycholera.com.
Cholera? Cholera?
Cholera is a deadly disease. Many people have died from cholera. But it sounds like a vegetable.
Yeah, it does. It does
sound like a vegetable. Cauliflower, like a weird kind of cauliflower alternative. I should Google cauliflower alternatives. No, I shouldn't.
No. Please don't.
What should I do, John?
I don't know. What should you do, Aaron? Aaron, what should you do? Oh, I got a funny thing. So, you know, I went to...
Did you have to pay 99 cents for it?
No.
Oh.
Do you?
I don't know. There's a game you can play in emojis? What? This is stupid. Did you see this? It's like a game. You don't just download it and then get the thing and then delete it. That's crazy.
You get it? It's on Earth.
I'm going to see if I get the emojis. Hold on. I need this. This is a very big deal for me. I don't think I do.
Have you downloaded it yet?
I've got emojis.
Yeah, but it just came out today, I think.
Yeah, but I deleted it. I might have a... I deleted it when I put it on the keyboards. You know what I mean? And I think that it updated itself at one point, because I got all the different color variations and all that shit.
You deleted it?
I deleted the app. I kept the keyboard, but I deleted the app.
Oh.
You know what I mean? So I didn't have to, like, have that app. I'm not going to fucking play this stupid little game, but now I might, because it's just like a... I received 400 bonus coins. I'm killing it on emojis right now. I don't want to rate it. No. No, I don't want that either. Bombshell. Hey. So, yeah, we're not going to do this anymore. I'm just going to play emojis games.
Well, no, on the podcast.
No. That'd be stupid. That would be a terrible thing for me to do.
So, I got a funny story.
Tell me about your funny story, please.
So, I was, you know, a couple weeks ago when you were out of town.
Yeah.
I went to Applefest.
So you went to Applefest and you didn't go to Irish Fest.
No.
Okay.
I don't support the white people.
Hey. Hey. Hey.
What the fuck are you doing?
Why not?
Are you playing that game?
No, I'm trying to find it on here. And it's hard to do. That's not on here. I can add a German with an Austria tinge keyboard if I wanted to. If I was banging a German girl.
But you're not.
No. Far from it.
So I went to Applefest, right?
Okay, and you went to Applefest in Weston, Missouri. Annual festival celebrating the wonders of the apple, even though most of it's about pumpkins and straw.
Holy shit, people can't see it.
What?
I just texted that to some people and
No.
It's only to other iPhone people.
Ew, gross. Exclusivity?
Oh.
No. Throw it away.
Oh.
You see that cell phone? See that trash can?
No.
Make them friends.
Oh no.
It's all over. The end is nigh. I think
you
it's
have
funny.
To boycott Apple now.
I think it's funny to have something like that playing as someone like a hate speech preacher. like fags in the military or something. Like that. That'd be super. It'd be terrible, but it'd be super funny.
We gotta get this country back to work.
I don't know. Get the Chinese out of here. Buddhist pieces of shit. Blacks shouldn't vote. Oh. Like, just imagine a Phelps, like, daughter yelling shit like that. Like, fags hate America or some shit.
Fags hate America.
Whatever they use fags for. It's everything. Like, just fags hate everything. Or they hate. They ruin everything. Fags are the reason they're not allowed in, like, 100 countries around the world. But old Topeka, Kansas just can't seem to get rid of them.
Oh.
I'm glad we talked about that. That's what emojis led to.
Okay, so I went to Applefest. Okay, so.
Oh, yeah, Applefest. Yeah, okay, yeah. Did you get some cider? Do they serve alcohol at Applefest? I know they have a bunch of root beer and cider and shit.
I didn't go to that part. I just went to, like, Weston on the weekend of Applefest.
So you didn't even go to Applefest?
No, I went to the bars.
Okay.
I went to the bunkhouse and...
Alone?
No, I met up with Michael and all my friends.
Guys. Yeah.
And so we met up at O'Malley's. It was pretty fun. That was fun.
Was it packed?
O'Malley's? O'Malley's was packed.
Okay.
But bunkhouse
was that a Friday?
Bunkhouse was the bunkhouse. Saturday? Bunkhouse was the bunkhouse.
I always wondered, like, I don't think I've ever gone to one of the bars on Applefest weekend. I wonder if there's, like, holdovers. Because it's a family festival.
Yeah.
More than, like, a
getting
Irish
drunk.
Fest. Yeah. So, yeah, I was just wondering if... I knew O'Malley's is usually packed Saturday regardless.
Yeah. I feel like I should have, like a yellow book. Because, like, I don't feel like I'm high enough.
I think you're fine.
No, I'm not.
Oh, you're very high, John. You fuck that. You're very high, John.
You're high.
So yeah, how was Applefest?
Okay, it was good. But the reason why I want to tell the story is because it has to do with the podcast.
Yeah.
And I think that's what it was. I don't think the earphone, we weren't loud enough in the earphone. We weren't plugged in all the way. Because
really?
We sound a lot fuller now, don't we?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. I don't know. It might just have been...
Oh, maybe I'm just drunk maybe enough where my ear... You
maybe
know, when you get drunk,
maybe
your ears...
Maybe you're a beer and a half drunk.
Yeah. Anyway.
Beer and a half drunk old.
It only took me almost 40 minutes.
So, yeah, Applefest.
So, like, I ran into a bunch of people. Uh-huh. And one of the people I ran into is Matt Driscoll.
Old fuddy duddies, huh?
Yeah. And Matt was like, you know, sometimes when I'm, like, bored at work and stuff like that, I listen to your podcast. And I'm like, oh, that's really awesome. Like, that's cool, man. That's awesome. And he's like, yeah. I'm like, you know, like, we just, you know.
Did we make fun of Matt Driscoll on a podcast?
No.
Okay.
Because, wait, he's going to make fun
anytime,
of
us. Anytime someone says, like, you know, I heard your podcast. I'm like, oh, shit. I know you. I've known you my whole life. Did I say something about... Did one of us say something about you?
No.
All right, go on.
I was like, you know, like, yeah, we are on SoundCloud. We're on YouTube. If you want to, like, we just went video-wise. You can check us out on YouTube. He's like, I'm just saying I sometimes listen to you guys. like, oh, I mean, I okay, I'm just saying, dude. But
that was too much of a commitment for Matt.
Right? Yeah.
It's like, oh. Hold on there, killer. I'm talking about Facebook. I'll listen to you all on Facebook. Not on that fucking YouTube. Granted,
I don't blame him.
I had such a time between the last time I was on SoundCloud and recently that I had to log in again.
Yeah.
Like, that's been like over a month since I've been back on SoundCloud.
We had a bunch of views on our last episode. Our last episode,
yeah, got the with Spencer and Christian.
Yeah,
for two and a half hour show.
Yeah,
we got like more views than we've gotten since from a Dennis Cheney episode.
Yeah,
like
when we did on the first video one, which got
it wasn't that one. It was It was like the between the first time he was on.
Was it the
third
Crows at Taco Bueno?
I think so. Yeah. Because it was after Acapulco Gold with Miguel. It was that one after, or before. It was the one before that one. So it was 28, number 28, I think.
Okay, nice.
20 episodes ago. That got like 90 views, or 90 listens.
Did it really?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
I don't know why. I mean, we've had Dennis on before, and he's been all right. Or, you know, the views have been all right, but...
But then, like, we did the video one that he did our...
Yeah, I didn't look at the YouTube views. I know the first one.
No, who do we have on our... Tristan. That one got, like, that one got, like, 80-something.
We got a good amount of YouTube views from that.
And plus, I tagged Taylor Swift in all of our videos.
What?
On YouTube.
Oh, really?
I do hashtag, hashtag Taylor Swift every time.
Yes! Tapping that market.
If you look on the pictures that I do, like, I do hashtag Taylor Swift on those, too. Because I'm fucking stoned when I do it.
You're just trying to get people to listen.
It's fucking hilarious. I think it's just stupid. It's stupid as shit.
That's hilarious.
Taylor Swift beard friendship. What the hell is this? What the hell is this thing?
Oh, that's fun. Good stuff.
Oh.
You know how to run a tight ship. That ship's tight.
That's always
tight,
like,
as a motherfucker.
That's always like dumping out like buckets of water at the same
time. Keep it tight. I'm gonna keep it tight.
You're tight.
John's on his phone, and that's the only thing that could come to his mind. You're tight. Oh,
okay,
thank you,
John. Thank you.
Means a lot.
So I have another story I want to tell you.
Yeah, please indulge Kevin.
So.
Old couch Kevin.
So.
Both spelled with K's. What's up?
So, recently I went to a quick trip.
Yeah.
And I was trying
to. It's a gas station.
Okay, it's a gas station. No, no.
Food mart.
And I was trying to purchase some beer, yeah. Right? Okay. So, like. Because I have a baby face, most of the time they ID me, which is totally fine. That's fine. But I've been reading up on and doing a little bit of research. Do you know why they scan? Do you know why they scan our IDs now?
Why?
It's so they can put us in a database and they mark us off.
Huh? They mark us off where?
They mark us off and they use it and they use the information to sell our information.
Oh, to market it to people our age, like what we're buying? No, that's fine.
How's that fine?
Google does the same thing. Google does it with everything you were looking up on your computer, as long as you do it through Google.
Or like I don't use Google.
Like on Google Chrome?
I don't use
what
Google.
What do you use? DuckDuck?
I don't use anything. I know everything.
Do you use Google Chrome or Safari?
I don't use anything. I told you I don't use anything.
I don't have a computer. Stupid. I have Encyclopedia Britannica.
What I do is, if I have a question, I say, Kevin, please come in my office. Kevin comes into my office. I ask
Kevin's like your secretary on Mad Men.
It's so I can stay underneath the radar.
Button. Kevin!
It's cause,
come inside!
It's because I don't want the government to know what I'm doing, so I go through Kevin... to see what everything is.
Oh, the government knows what you're doing.
No,
you have a podcast. They know full well what you're doing. Oh, hey, speaking of what you're doing, Missouri might pass marijuana.
Hey.
You think it's over, but it's not. What a terrible show. It doesn't get much worse.
This is what happens every time we get a new sound effect. We overuse it the very first time.
It's just like you and I. Yeah. Like, it's you and I. It's like, oh, well. What are we going to do? Oh, we can talk about some stupid shit. That's the perfect sound effect, though. It's long and stupid and loud.
But if you listen to amateur podcasts, we're pretty sure that we're pretty much the best ones.
Hands down.
Hands down the best.
At least the best in the Ethan's apartment complex in North Kansas City, Missouri. Hands down, top five.
Hands down.
I don't know. This is a big apartment complex. I don't know what everyone else is doing.
It's true.
They might have an Ethan's Watch podcast. You know what I mean?
Well, like, this week on Ethan's,
like, it's a 10-minute long kind of news bulletin. Like, they talk about the Halloween party they're gonna have in like a week.
You gonna read it?
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
This is
adorable.
Real, like, this was like,
they're gonna have pizza. I'm showing up. They're gonna have pizza. It's the 28th. It's not even on Halloween. Perfect. I'm gonna show up. I need some 28th. Yeah. What day is that? That's like a
Wednesday.
It's
in 7 days.
It is a Wednesday. Man. Both of us are simpatico.
Simpatico. Is
that, yeah, sure. Come join us at our annual Halloween party. The Ethan's Main Clubhouse. We will be serving Minsky's Pizza. Delicious.
So come out and have...
It's pretty goddamn good.
Is it? Is it better than Pizza Hut?
Oh, yeah.
Shut up. It is. Don't lie to me here.
We also will be having a pumpkin carving contest. We gotta brush up on our pumpkin carving.
Oh, you haven't been practicing?
Well, I've been practicing on people. It doesn't work.
It doesn't count, Aaron, when you do it that.
If I just carve up the people, they don't really look very happy like the pumpkins. Bring your pre-carved pumpkins. Pumpkins. I'm done. I've said it all. Pumpkins.
Finish it.
I want to say it was a tongue twister, but it's not. I'm not even drunk. Like, this is bullshit. Bring your pre-carve pumpkins, not cumkins, to enter and win. Oh, first place you get a tablet.
Oh, shit, really?
Second place you get a $100 Best Buy gift card. Huh? Oh, you got an RSVP?
It's kind of gay.
No, I'm still gonna go. Like, Christine's the fucking manager here. I'll show up. I know Christine on a personal level.
Yes, you do. That you do.
I've drunkenly made out with her before. God damn it! I know what I'm doing.
Who doesn't know what you're doing?
I'll bring my post carved pumpkin.
Cumpkin.
It's like a blumpkin. The old toilet seat blowjob. Now, is a blump... John, are you familiar with a blumpkin?
Yes. No.
Is it?
I'm familiar of what it is, but I've never done one.
Well, is it... Do you have to be shitting?
I would say you'd have to be for it to...
I think you're right, but I don't want something to be that fucked up for me to think about it so much. You know? I love the sound of the word blumpkin. So I say it a lot. I say it a lot in my head. But like usually with me, I'm just thinking like, oh, he found the nearest seat, and it was the toilet.
Have you ever thought of like how they came up with those words for,
like Urban Dictionary stuff?
Yeah. Like they have one for like a cunk queen, like a cunk king or cunk queen is like when you watch like your partner have sex with someone else.
Like a cuckolding.
Cuckold is that? Well, that's.
I think so.
Yeah, like
I don't know.
Cuckolding, like still, that's no.
Cuckolding's an older word though.
I know, but that's like that
like
doesn't
a cuck
make
queen.
That doesn't make any more sense.
Well, usually, like
than what
usually,
I just said.
Usually, they're. Oh, I guess. don't know what I was just thinking, but I'm trying to, like, you know, rationalize the naming it a blumpkin.
Yeah.
I can't. Like, it's a blowjob pumpkin. That's not a thing. That's not you sitting on a toilet. Like, the guy getting the first blumpkin wasn't like, I'm a pumpkin. You know? He was getting a blowjob like, I'm taking a shit, too. Like, that's what he was doing. That's what he was saying. Like, I'm also taking a shit. I'm about to come in your mouth. Don't go down there. You know? Like, don't even lick my balls. There's some splash. You don't want that splash. I don't know what kind of shit came out of my butt, either. I'm a pumpkin getting a blowjob.
I don't know what I eat.
I have bad eating habits. I'm a pumpkin getting a blowjob. That's
maybe,
the only way
I can... Maybe that's what it was. Maybe it was a pumpkin getting a blowjob.
What, like Humpty Dumpty?
No, maybe it was, what's his name? The Sleepy Hollow dude. Maybe he was getting...
the headless horseman. He never had a pumpkin for a head.
But yeah, he did. This one is...
I'm pretty sure movie. That was just adapted. Like, oh, well, we gotta make it kind of scary. You know, give him a head.
A pumpkin
head? You can't just have him be like a skull head. Was he like a pumpkin? That movie, Pumpkin Head, is a movie.
Maybe
it's a horror movie.
Maybe that's what I'm thinking. Maybe it was him.
I don't think in Sleepy Hollow they gave him a pumpkin head.
I'm pretty
I think
sure
he
was
did. Just,
I think
well,
he got
because
one.
Because then he wouldn't be the headless horseman. He would have a head.
He'd just be the pumpkin head guy.
I'm no longer the headless horseman, everybody. Look at this sweet ass shit. Got me a pumpkin. Guess who I am now? Go ahead, guess. Get ready for that. Go ahead, motherfucking guess. I'm the pumpkin head guy. Bow down, motherfuckers. It's a pumpkin head guy.
No, I'm pretty sure the Sleepy Hollow dude also had a pumpkin as a head. If we have any fans that actually listen to us, Google it.
Google.
Make a meme and come back to us.
Don't make a meme. I hate people who make memes.
We
dude, man, that's
we
so
have
annoying.
We have people we have fans that make memes all the
yeah,
time.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're funny as shit.
Michael makes memes. Michael's memes are good. But they're not really memes though. They're just pictures with words on them. I don't like the
it is a meme.
The loose term of the word meme.
Then what would you call what he does then?
I don't want to call it memeing.
It's better than memeing?
No, it's just he's making pictures with words on them. People have been doing that forever. No one ever called them memes.
Your mom calls them memes.
We should have my parents on.
Can we? Can we have your dad on?
Probably not. I don't know.
Why? Your dad would listen to my mom.
My dad. My mom. Having my mom on would be funny, but my dad on, it would be... That would be crazy shit, because... I don't know. It'd be weird. Maybe, like, for the 100th episode, we'll have my parents on. How's that?
Okay.
And for the 1,000th episode, we'll find your real parents and have them on. Good luck, everybody!
If you want to help us... If you guys want to help us out, you guys can...
But my dad has seen me drunk more than my mom, which is weird. Because I tell my mom most of the stuff I've, you know, done. I don't tell my dad that much.
Really?
Like, I told my mom, I don't know. Like, my dad was always the authority figure. So I got into the act of, like, not telling him stuff. Like, it's none of his business, really. And my mom, like, I don't know. What's she gonna do? My dad will, like...
Call cops?
My dad will be like, well, you're turning into your brother. Or he's not going to say anything like that, but I think he might. And I don't want that to happen. My mom will just, like... Well, Aaron, you're not as bad as the rest of them, you know? Like, you're not your sister or your brother. Which is, you know... You're still a little drunk! But, yeah, you're fine! You know?
True.
Yeah, if we could get them on, that'd be fun. My mom can't drink, my dad can drink.
Why can't your mom drink?
She's on medication and shit. I don't know. She hasn't drank for a long time.
Mm.
But she's told me stories of, like, when she used to do acid and get drunk all the time and do all this shit, like, back in the 70s. She was an interesting person. My dad used to do the same shit, but...
They had you and... Things changed.
And my brother.
Things changed.
Everything changed. Everything has changed. You want to do missed connections? Do you have your iPad with you?
Yeah.
Hey.
Aaron, of course I have.
I couldn't see it. It was all black. All
right. So I guess, we're going to do... You just need to refresh. Go back. And then we'll just do missed connections. So, guys, this is
the last time.
Yeah, this is missed connections, guys.
This is ridiculous.
People hate us. If we had any listeners, we lost.
We already knew people hate us.
But if we had any listeners, we lost them now. Because like, okay, dude, we're done with that.
Oh, no.
Kevin's over here like, what the fuck?
Kevin's even thinking like, guys, this is getting old.
Is it Kevin?
Is that
you want us to do it again? Okay.
That was
for you, Kevin.
So long. So nice to have Kevin back.
I think he's halfway through, like, all the...
You think it's going to end, and it's like... boo. God damn. All
right, okay, so what's the first misconnection?
Okay, so this one's called White Guy for Black Beauty. Love all thick, pretty girls. Man for woman, Kansas City,
hey,
Kansas.
Did I write this? Sounds like someone wrote it.
Might have. Age 33.
I'm not 33.
Let me try this out. That's never a good sentence. I'm 33, white, with a few tattoos. Great job. Now you decide to use commas. Own my own place. That's not how you end. I love to make people laugh, and I'm a gentleman. Plural. He is multiple men. He is multiple nice men, everybody. He is a gentleman.
First six pack. Done.
We did it. I love to kiss.
It only took us an hour. We're going to do like a... We're doing a three-hour podcast tonight. Because
Austin's going to show up eventually. There's no doubt he'll show. He'll get on the podcast. I love to kiss. That's a weird thing to put, right? Like, who doesn't...
Hey, third? Kevin. Do you like to kiss?
Do you love to kiss? Kevin, it's a thumbs up and a head shake.
Yeah.
With a confident turn towards the video game. Kevin loves to kiss. But he wouldn't put it in a Craigslist ad. Yeah. I love to kiss, and I'm very sexual, and have a flexible schedule.
Because I have no job.
I think he did. But
I have a car that has really good gas mileage.
This is the last sentence. Our royals and nailing it and. What? That's it. That's absolutely it. Our royals and nailing it and.
This is the episode name.
That's like when they interviewed this one Yankees baseball player. About what it's like to play baseball, and he was like, they don't know how it do, but it be, or some shit like that.
Royals and...
nailing. Our Royals and nailing and... I have no... I think that guy had a stroke as he was finishing, and he was like, and has to be my last word.
And...
Oh, no. What? What is going on? Oh, can we talk about the title of the podcast a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, which one?
The dog will hunt.
Oh, I didn't get it.
That dog can hunt?
That dog can hunt. What is that from?
The phrase is, that dog will hunt. It's an idiom.
That dog will hunt.
That dog will hunt. That means that thing will work. Okay. Basically. That dog can hunt. Like, there, like you, that's like if the idiom had doubt. Like, that dog can hunt, man. Goddamn.
That was the joke.
Yeah, but Christian all night had been saying, that dog will hunt. That's the phrase. You take it, you take the writing shit in your own hands and you goof it. But it was funny either way.
Maybe I'm trying to do a joke upon a joke upon a joke.
We just don't get you.
It's a hat on a hat.
You're so alt.
It's a hat on a hat.
It's a hat with a hat.
Maybe that's what it is. I don't know what the saying.
That's not a saying either.
Yeah, it is. It's a writing saying. It's like a hat on really? A hat, where it's like a joke upon a joke. It's like, because like one, like his, how he was saying it, but then I ended up doing it a completely different way. But it was a joke because it was supposed to be like a lost in translation moment. Hat on a hat. Someone Google it.
That should have been the time.
We have enough fans now that we can, we have enough fans now that there's going to be alien, like Aaronites, and there's going to be Johnnites.
Alienites. Sounds like a porno. Alienites.
Aaronite. I forgot to tell you, I actually am in production right now of making my next film. It is an adult film.
Called Alienites.
And I'm going to, my goal is to record the perfect facial.
Oh, man. How are you going to do that?
Just give a bunch of girls facials.
Like massages?
Yeah.
Just got to get that girl feeling good. Oh, God. Okay. Number two. Are you ready, America?
Yes.
I was asking America. I just want a weekly regular, man for woman, independence. I think this guy's just asking for a meth dealer. Body, average, height, 6'3", status,
divorced.
Age, 47. Poor guy, so tall and old. I'm looking for a petite, skinny woman, approximately between 5 foot and 5'4".
You know you have the iPad upside down.
I was just gripping on the thing, the grapple thing. That felt good. I enjoyed that. Oh, it's way better. Way better upside down. Here we go. No more than 120 pounds. This guy's just grabbing at straws here. Must be on BC and like bareback.
Birth control.
Birth control, okay. And like bareback and receiving oral sex. At least once a week to meet... And I can host. That's not a good sentence. Always fresh and shaved, please. Jesus Christ. Just say you want to fuck an 18-year-old. Just say it. That's all I want. That's all I want him to say.
That's all you want him to say?
I will take care of you. That's it. That's all he wants. But put petite in subject line if you really want this. I'm a young 47. If you're Alec Baldwin,
that's a young 47.
Then you're a young 47.
Or Joe Rogan.
How old's Joe Rogan?
He's 47.
Oh shit! Wow, he's a young 47. Because he's got money, he can get killer facials. And HWP, what's that mean?
We're gonna do a scene with them, actually.
What's HWP mean?
HW.
Hot wet pussy.
Yeah.
No. Oh, huge white penis. I'm a young 47 and HWP.
Huge white penis?
That's not a... That doesn't make sense, though. It's not a good place... I don't know why I'm...
It's Craigslist.
It's not a good place to put those.
He's not grammatically correct.
Okay, there's an Urban Dictionary for it. Height, weight proportional. Okay. That's weird. Usually they're sexual acronyms.
Yeah.
Or shortenings. Height, weight proportional. Okay. Please send a pic to show me you're tiny. And he used the wrong your, so it leads me to think that he's like, show me your tiny what? Show me your tiny clit. Show me your tiny pee-pee. Just show me your tiny hands. Show me your tiny swole of your back. Show me a tiny ankle. Man. Can't figure out beer tonight. Hard to swallow. That should be a Craigslist title.
What?
Hard to swallow. I don't know what it'd be about, but... Numero 30. Any real, all caps, wild girls. Leavenworth County, man for woman. Of course he's got an athletic body. He's 6'3", single, and 40 years old. Looking for real hot and kinky party girl. No bullshit. You come to me. Pick for pick. Don't ask for verification, because if you do, you're fake! All caps. I'm verified on multiple sites. What does that mean? PNP, who wants to blast off to the moon. What? What does PNP stand for? Here we go. We're diving in. Party and play means drugs, often meth. Great. Well, he is from Leavenworth County, Kansas. Now that I know that, the thing he said after PMP is just that much better. PMP, who wants to blast off to the moon? Hit Mr. Up. Ain't nothing real here. Man, what is going on? Did you read this? Did you see all the weird little things going on in that paragraph? That's great. Like, just don't even look at the, like, the, you know, the errors and shit. Just the thought process of putting it all together is hilarious. Who wants to go to the moon?
You're fake.
That's beautiful. That's what Craigslist was made for. Just that kind of shit show. Oh, shit. Slipper beers. Oh, that's heavy.
We can't.
What was it?
It's long.
Is it very racist? Oh no. Too long. Justin!
Oh, hello, fellas.
What's up, pup?
You came in and you ruined it!
Oh, man!
Are you guys about to start?
No, we've been going on for, like, an hour. You can join in if you want.
We're an hour and seven in.
Okay. We got another solid 40.
Oh, nice. You guys started late.
Pumping out. Well, I got off at 9:30, so.
Oh, okay.
And we had to set up and shit. Okay, here we go. Short and sweet. BJ in the car sounds nice. Returned favor. What are you going to do, give her a blowjob? That's ridiculous. Independence. Everything is from Independence tonight. As the title says, end of sentence. Really just want a BJ. I imagine this is the type of Craigslist ad that Miguel would have sent out like 4 years ago. Or like maybe 2 years ago. On or near the square, which is, I don't know what that is. I'll return the favor if you want. I am real, .. Royals are coming home for the next game or two. What does that mean? That was the last sentence. Royals are coming home for the next game or two. Why do all these Independence people have to put in some weird kind of thing about the Royals at the end? Oh, you missed the first one. What did the guy say? I think he wrote it down at the end. His thing. Oh my god. Kevin, shut up. It's unplugged so the noise doesn't be noise.
Oh.
John did it.
Okay.
John doesn't like sound.
I don't like John's mouth making sounds.
Yeah, John, shut up. Jesus.
That's why I don't read.
Two-thirds vote.
I think he talks.
Yeah, John, fuck. Be quiet, man.
I'm stealing some ice out of your cooler.
You can have some beer, too.
That's a lot of beer.
It is.
Is it all yours?
No. Kevin bought the blue. John bought the red.
Okay.
Oh, this is close to home. Airport hotel, man for woman. Alone, horny, bored. The only word there not capitalized was bored. I get it. Staying in one of our fine KC airport properties? Oh, that was a question. 50W dominant. WM dominant. What? White male. Okay, yeah. WM stands for white male. Dominant. Guys, read this carefully. Women or couples only. I will come to you and take you the way you want to be taken. This is Liam Neeson. Or the people he wants to kill in those movies, Taken.
The new Taken for granted. Get it?
Taken 4. That's like, you know, the Live Free or Die Hard.
If he would spend half as much energy like to get his daughter back as into like just keep her safe.
Watch your motherfucking mouth.
John Cena.
That was for you, Austin.
Yeah, we've played it like what, 7 times? That's the new intro and outro for everything. So
I think you should have John Cena's intro.
John Cena.
That'd be amazing.
Okay, so this is I will come to you and take you the way you want to be taken, naturally. After which, you will drift off to sleep, well fucked and satisfied. Man, he's got it all planned. This is in his iPod notes. iPod, iPhone. No names, no games, just straight anonymous fucking. If your man is with you and wants to watch, that's fine too. Put the name of your hotel on the subject. Include a picture. I will respond with a picture. If you like what you see, respond with a room number and a telephone number I can text you at. You can be full of cock before midnight. That's every girl's dream. Right before she puts the fucking, you know, the crystal slipper on, becomes the old princess. Full of cock. Did you steal some pizza from work?
No, this is my pizza.
Oh.
I brought my own.
Full of cock before midnight. Oh. What the hell? Oh, are we on Casual Encounters? No. Yeah, we are.
Are we?
Casual Encounters.
Is it?
Did we just start on Casual Encounters from the get-go? No, let me read that one. Did we do Misconnections at all? Okay, anyway, I think we've been on Casual Encounters the whole time, because, yeah, we did Casual Encounters with Miguel. Oh, no. We didn't even do any Misconnections tonight.
You want to do...
I didn't even realize that. We just read it and make fun of them. We don't even think about, like, their strife and struggle and, like, how it's different from the other one.
I know.
Oh, God. We're monsters, John.
I know.
We're monsters. But it's still funny. Submissive for slut training. Man for woman. Kansas City.
Even if that's a misconnection, that could be a misconnection or...
Yeah, that's what I... they're so closely related.
They almost intertwine with each other.
The best part about this is it's a picture of a woman masked, except everything is masked. Like it's like one of those
horse things, like one of those like horse masks
to get the horse to sleep. That'd be funny if they just took the kind of mask that she's wearing and then like stretched out the mouth hole for the horse's nose and mouth. Like, yeah, put this sex mask on the horse so it'll clean. Got a big race tomorrow. But she's got lipstick on. So it's a passion party. Or a rainbow party, sorry. Seeking submissive slave for slut training. Slut training. Every time I say that, John coughs. Slut training.
It's my trigger word.
That's it. You will be trained to treat each man as you would your husband. What? Learn to get pleasure through submission and giving pleasure to any man who you are instructed to please. Training will be started using a hood so that neither you or the man you are pleasing will know what the other looks like. New experiences will be added as training progresses. Reply with a picture and put your age in the subject line. That'd be funny if it like if they put a hood on her and they just drove to a KKK rally and they unhooded her. It's like, welcome! We can't, nobody wants to join the KKK anymore. That's the easiest way to get them. Stockholm Syndrome. Alright, we gotta get to some, the old misconnection. We're losing listeners.
Again, that was for you, Kevin.
Kevin, we love you.
We're either winning or extremely losing.
Which do you want to go? God, there's a...
I think Kevin's really the only winner tonight.
Tall black lady or furniture deals?
Furniture deals.
All right, furniture deals. Man for woman, Belton. Athletic body, 5'10", married, 23, poor guy. I keep seeing you in furniture deals. This guy's reading. This guy's looking at Nebraska Furniture Mart. The worst I've seen, John. Ever. Ever. This is the funniest, this is the hardest I've seen you laugh. Is reading furniture catalogs and thinks it, well, my only chance is misconnections. This is great. Oh no.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Oh my god.
This guy's going to IKEA, picking up their magazines. Go, that's my girl. Always looking good in front of those beds. Ooh, a chair.
Oh my.
Okay. You know, going into this, I was like, furniture deals, what could that mean? And of course, it's this. Naturally, it's... You know, I was perusing through some catalogs I found at Walmart. Boom, there you were. The love of my life. Alright, I'll start over.
Sorry, everyone.
Again, this is in Belton, Missouri.
I need to take a sip.
That was hilarious. Oh, man. Oh my god, we're getting back to our roots. Solo casts. Just goofing it up. Goofballing it. Gaffs. Lots of gaffs. Lots of Jim Gaffigans. We're Gnome Chomities.
This is what happens when it's just you and I on.
We get goofy.
We get all silly.
We get all goofy.
We get all silly dilly on everyone.
We're just playing around, bro.
Just silly dilly.
Just playing goofs, playing gaffs, playing alongs. I keep seeing you in furniture deals. You look attractive and very sexy. You tell me you don't want a boyfriend. Email me if you're the one and let's get together and have some fun. This guy's insane. I think that's the bottom line to this. This guy is batshit crazy. And he's letting a catalog talk to him. Okay, so this is the new one. Oh man, this guy's tall. This one's called, this is the other options, the tall black lady.
Okay, tall black lady.
Man for woman, Shawnee Walmart. Which is a place. It's a town, Shawnee Walmart, Kansas.
I've been to that Walmart many a time.
Maybe you've seen her. Body types, athletic.
My cheeks hurt.
You were about to cry.
I was crying.
Height, 6'8". Widowed. Oh no.
Ooh.
The black lady at Walmart, Shawnee, today around 5 p.m., you wearing a pharmaceutical black glass with long black sleeve, and I think a long brown pan?
Pan.
This girl went as a bowl of fried rice to work. And I think, let me read that again. Hold on. There's no end of the sentence. It's all just gibberish and bullshit. The black lady at Walmart, Shawnee, today around 5 p.m., you wearing a pharmaceutical black glass, which isn't a thing, with long black sleeve, also one sleeve, and I think a long brown pan. Got like a griddle like attached to her necklace. Oh no. Oh, that was the end of that sentence. You were buying things with your key in your fingers. I want to meet you because you attracted me. This guy doesn't know how to use words. I can't, help me, Kevin. I can't even imagine what he meant when he wrote, I think, a long brown pan. What? What are you trying to tell us?
He's in your fingers.
Oh my god!
Keys in her fingers.
You were buying things with keys in your fingers. Hey, bro, look at that bitch. Yeah, what's up? She's wearing a long brown pan. Oh shit! Bitch got a pan.
Oh shit!
Man, I'm sure glad we found out we weren't on Craigslist or on Misconnections. Holy shit. What a shit fest. Long brown pan. Yeah, she really wore that long brown pan. I just imagine like Beyonce and Jay-Z on the red pants. Beyonce and Jay-Z on the red carpet and somebody comes up to her, Beyonce, and she's like, Beyonce, who are you wearing tonight? Oh, it's a long brown pan.
Sizzle.
You can put your meat. You can throw your meat on the side on my long brown pan. But once it gets cooked, it's gonna fall off.
So you gotta catch it.
Yeah. You gotta flip. You gotta catch it. Flip it. Throw it again. Wait for it to cook all the way through again. And then only eat around the edges. It's not going to cook all the way through. George Foreman start selling the long, like the short brown pan. Like, this is just the easier way to do it.
Sports sex, you're more slick.
Beautiful brunette at Dix. Can't spell brunette. Man, you're just right for the picking. Right. Beautiful brunette at Dix Sporting Goods. Man for woman, Olathe, Kansas.
Oh my god, he's from a nice part of town.
I was behind you in the checkout line today, Friday in parentheses. You had short brown hair, were wearing a short patterned dress, had a gray purse. You're fucking up your commas. You had the cutest smile and an amazing body. You used a coupon off of your phone for yourself, and the guy you were with, he, in parentheses, he was wearing a red shirt. If you're that guy, watch out. Dot, dot, dot. I even circled the parking lot to make sure my eyes weren't deceiving me.
Because your competition is the guy who can't spell for that.
I like that last line. I even circled the parking lot to make sure my eye... That's what you say when you're trying to not, like, give it away that you're a stalker. No, I was just driving around. I was like, holy shit, that girl's amazing! You've been following her for hours. You weren't wearing a ring, so I'm assuming you weren't married. Even if you are, get in touch with me. If you know what I look like or what I was driving, of course she knows what you were driving. You circled around her like a fucking vulture to a carcass. Let me know. Super long shot, but here's to hope. Here's to hope. Man. You used a coupon off your phone. Hey, I was just looking at your phone really quick. I noticed you had a coupon. You should fucking use it. Use your coupon.
Did you use something off of it?
Hey, you can use your coupon for those Mizunos. cleats. Oh, you're 16 years old. That's not your brother. Fuck. Okay, this is gonna be the last one. I'm just gonna read this headline because I love it. Beautiful woman at Applebee's. That's all we needed. Oh, yeah, this one's in Lawrence. I've been to this place before. All right, we're gonna do that. It's this might not be good, but.
Might not
jazz
be bad.
House is a familiar place. I will be at the Jazz House November 13th.
Really?
Yes.
November 13th.
For Joke Fighter, the finals. Go to it. I'm going to talk about it later when okay. I plug. But okay. You, microphone, go to my show. Okay, this is Jazz House, Saturday, Man for Woman, Lawrence, Kansas. You were wearing a white vest with a fuzzy hood, but claimed it didn't impede your ability to outdrink my friend. Why would a hood... I was a singer from Topeka, there, those don't exist, who invited you to karaoke. So you're a karaoke guy. I had a great time talking with you. If you would like to do it again sometime, respond with the name of the alcohol you claimed you could drink us under the table with. What was that stuff we drank in Chicago?
I know, that's what I was thinking too.
Was it called a... Oh, shit. God. It started with an M.
Enough?
I want to say it's like Malort. Malort. Malort.
There it is.
Oh, God.
There
Jesus.
It is. There it was.
Christ in it.
Malort!
Ta! Malort. Yeah, that's what's in Chicago. This is Malort.
Malort.
It's the worst
shit in the world.
When I drank it, I put on a tough face. My insides were not tough for Malort. Okay, we're gonna do today. I learned.
Okay, today
we learned. Sorry, the things we learned this week. I'm just reading it off Reddit. The joke doesn't get old. Oh, I think I did. I say any of them last week?
I don't remember, to tell you the truth.
I think I did. Okay. Sorry. I saved some from last week, because I figured, you know, why not? Oh, this one's fun. You know the Susan G. Komen Foundation, the breast cancer?
Yeah. What about
they them? Sue other charities over the use of the word cure. Also, this isn't from this, but they use 98% of the money not for curing breast cancer. So there's that. Ooh, this one's got to do with the Denver Broncos, which is cool. The Broncos unretired the number 18 jersey for Peyton Manning. Its original wearer was an assistant coach who, after injuries and poor play, stepped in as quarterback and became the first one to throw for 1,000 yards in the season. Really? Holy shit! Who was it? Yeah, play it. Sorry. I did not know about this. I think it was, what? Al Carton? Who? No. No. Frank Tripica. What the fuck's a Frank Tripica? What? Well, I give up. We're not done, sorry. hold on. I gotta find it. There's a prison in Finland where the only thing keeping the inmates in is a yellow picket fence. Because Finland does the whole rehabilitation thing right. And people don't want to leave. It's a nice, comfortable prison. They can hang out. They know what they did. And also, I think the maximum sentence in most of Europe is like 25 years.
Because they don't do anything that bad?
There's no... Well, they do, but there's no life sentences that Why? I know of. It's kind of inhumane.
So
granted, they deserve it. You know, if they killed somebody, but... Definitely no death penalty that I know of. So that was what we learned this week that I just pulled out of my ass on the cell phone. Pew 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 pew.
Pew pew pew.
Yeah. That was- Play them all, sport.
God, I bet Austin's like, God damn it. Kevin's like, God damn it.
Kevin's like, yeah, like Kevin didn't have to put up with this for like over a month, and now he's in the thick of it.
The intern's back. He's back.
Intern's back. I don't know where I was going with that song, but it's a song now, so hey! Fuck you, Tina Turner. What?
You didn't finish that beer up there.
I did. Don't fret. My pet, I'm good. We did it.
You did it?
The beer is gone.
All of it?
No, we still have like 9. Oh, yeah, like 11. We have 11 beers. You want beer?
Might as well.
Yeah, why not? You only live often, right?
True.
Cholo. That was a weird burp.
But I appreciated it.
So, Aaron.
Yeah? Oops. Sorry, table. You deserve better. Oh, God.
Well, you know what, guys?
We're the worst.
I know. Well,
we're like, I think I'm only 4 beers deep. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Jeez.
I just started on my 4th.
Wow, we're really pacing together here.
We're like an hour and 33 minutes into it.
Do we have something else to talk about?
Well,
I don't remember.
We could just have random stuff. Did you know Homeland, the TV show Homeland?
Yeah, I've never watched it.
You know, like, when they do, like, stuff, like, overseas stuff that they have to do, you know, they have to do all of the production design.
Yeah.
Well, what they do is they have to hire people who can, like, write Arabic.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And so, apparently, the people who've been, like, writing the Arabic stuff have been making fun of Homeland. Saying,
really?
Saying, like, it's not funny and it's not accurate and stuff like that.
Well, it's not supposed to be funny, so that helps.
Yeah. I thought that was funny.
I need to start watching that show, though. I've heard it's good.
They make
and it's got Claire Danes in it.
They I make like up Claire all Danes. The stuff, though. It's a show.
Yeah, it's a Showtime TV.
I know.
They've got to make something up so they can combat, you know, Game of Thrones and everything HBO's doing. HBO's killing it. Can we talk about the Chiefs now? They suck?
Yeah.
Perfect. Chiefs suck. Isn't Jamal Charles out for the season now?
Yeah, he's out for the season.
Poor guy. That sucks for him.
Torn ACL.
Fuck that shit. This is the only sport where they will tear every kind of, like, MCL, PCL, ACL, all of them. Who tore, wasn't it, I think it was Roethlisberger, and, like, the year after they won the Super Bowl, they were in the playoff game against Cincinnati, and he threw, like, it was a Hail Mary, and the guy caught it, but during the tackle, or the sack, the attempted sack, the guy on the Bengals fucked his knee up. He tore all three of those things. ACL, PCL, MCL. That's fucking insane. It's the only sport that'll happen. Unless, like, there's an accident in basketball.
Yeah.
But in football, it's like,
Or NASCAR.
I just slammed on the brakes too hard. But God, I remember seeing that shit. That was, like, I think 2008, 2007. Back when the Bengals, I think they had Kittner?
Carson, was it Carson?
Oh, yeah, it was Carson Palmer, yeah. No, that was Palmer. That's who it was. It wasn't Roethlisberger, it was Carson Palmer, because he was in this prime and Pittsburgh won. That was when they won the Super Bowl. So, yeah, that was Palmer. That was the year that, because he was drafted, what, 2004, 2003, I think? But, yeah, that was first or second round of the playoffs, because they were playing, you know,
I'm glad you reminded me of something. Carson Palmer, because he's from USC.
Yeah.
Did you hear about what the USC fired their head coach?
Yeah, because they're drunk.
I know. Isn't that funny? Sucks.
That reminded me of Danny Brown. But I was gonna say Carson Palmer's really reinvented his career in Arizona. He's doing really well down there.
Yeah.
Good for him. I always liked Carson Palmer.
I've never liked any of the USC quarterbacks.
Well, because most of them suck shit.
They've all.
Like, Mark Sanchez has been terrible. John David Booty's been terrible. Matt Castle's been terrible.
Matt Castle never started there.
I know. He had one season with the Patriots with a perennial, you know, Super Bowl team and went 10-6 with them.
Yeah.
Didn't even make the playoffs. I'm like, oh, he's. Yeah, sign
him. He's a good quarterback. He's a good quarterback. And
the worst of them all.
Who signed him? The Chiefs.
The worst of them all, though, was Matt Leinart.
Yeah.
Because at least Sanchez got the Jets to the AFC Championship 2 years in a row.
Yeah.
Even if he wasn't, like just, you know, flat out great. He was a good quarterback for a couple of years, and then he imploded. But and John David Booty wasn't a starter, and Castle never really deserved to start, other than
but
the fact
somehow
that he was backup.
He always finds work.
I know. Yeah, it's backup for the Vikings now, isn't he?
He's not who's the starter for the Vikings?
Bridgewater?
Yeah.
I guess he's doing all right. Bridgewater, I think Teddy Bridgewater is going to be a good quarterback.
Maybe. Oh.
I hope he is, because the Vikings need a good quarterback.
Bridgewater, because he went to Louisville.
Yeah.
Did you hear about the scandal at Louisville?
Yeah, with Patino?
Yeah.
He's such an idiot. He gets in all this hot water shit. Fucking Patino.
What I love about it, the whole thing
didn't
was...
He got caught with a prostitute, like, not 5 years ago.
Yeah. And the funny thing is, what makes me laugh about the whole thing is the fact he's like, well, I didn't know anything was going on. You coached the fucking Miami Heat.
Yeah.
The most shadiest team out of the whole NBA.
Patino's always done a really good job of just, like, playing it off. Like he's but got, what's that, so he's funny got is, that mafia kind of.
He looks like he's looked like he's in the mob.
He's from around there.
Yeah. So I like, mean, why are you Italian? So shocked? Why are you so shocked that he's doing that shit?
I mean, I'm honestly surprised he hasn't gotten caught for betting on games or anything like that. Like anything having to do with money, it's all true. Just been women.
Just which, you fucking them. Just yeah. fucking them, paying and for money.
Like yeah, like we're gonna send you some hookers. That's a weird thing for a coach to tell you.
What's so funny is like the players are like, yeah, we had sex with some hookers.
Yeah. Do something.
Like what's?
Oh, you're gonna suspend? I'm still. You're gonna not let me play basketball anymore? Oh no, that's one thing I don't like.
What I don't understand is, like, these schools, these organizations know that these scandals are about to occur. Yeah. Why don't they just say, hey, just shh. We're about to lose a shit ton of money. You think that they would try to do something because they're going to lose money?
There are so many colleges, so many major colleges. Like, just you think the NFL is big with, like, 30 teams. There's 10 teams in a huge conference.
Yeah.
You know, in basketball and football. There's scandals going on all the fucking time. It's just the ones that get out are like, oh my god, I never even thought about it. You know, like, in a college? In a major college?
But they act so fucking shocked. They act so shocked when your fucking coach has greasy, slick back hair. And he looks like, he wears like a slightly overly sized
suit. He's been around
suit.
Forever, and he probably thinks he can get away with it.
He's jumped from NBA to NCAA like it's nothing. He's the only coach that's been able to go and forth.
Good for him.
Like, you really get
your players, make your players happy. Get them laid if you can. I'm not saying he did it. He probably didn't have much to do with it.
But he was
off fucking somebody else, not his wife. Because that's what Rick Pitino does. But if Louisville, Kentucky, is a major college scandal, think about all the other shit happening, like Notre Dame, USC, you know, like MU, KU, Florida State, all these huge state colleges. Just think, like, what is going on there that nobody knows about?
Yet.
I want to know. Like, I don't think it's a bad thing. Fuck all you people you want. Who cares?
Yeah.
You're a basketball player. You have to do something with that kind of, like, you know, like, recognition. Like, you're a talented athlete. You're not getting paid. No, I mean, the college,
you're getting exploited.
The university is making millions off of you. You're not seeing shit. You don't have time to work because you got to go to practice in the morning. Yep. And you don't have time to do anything else except for, you know, homework. But the in-between time, go fuck a hooker. Who cares? Who cares? Go fuck a hooker. Have sex with a hooker. Do what you want. You're a bad... They need to pay them.
Yeah.
Something. You know, just enough to live.
I'm
Because
I'm
it's a job. You know, it's a job. As soon as they get into the NFL draft, they're doing the exact same thing. And they can still go to college. You know? Like, they can still go to college online or do whatever and be a student.
What is that? That Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald did that.
Did Larry Fitzgerald?
Phoenix University.
Yeah. I mean, there was a...
Or he got paid to do that and he got it on
I read about it the other day. There was a football player, a baseball player who got hurt and he was out for like 6 or 7 months. He finished his degree online at the same school he went to in college.
Yeah.
But he's getting paid, you know, like... professional dollars for his skill. It's bullshit. I'm not saying they should get, you know, $10 million a year, because that's ridiculous. But give them, like, a livable wage. You know, they don't even have enough time to work at the Starbucks on campus.
Yeah.
That's, you know, they don't have time to work at the fucking Pink Berry or Froyo, whatever.
Froyo?
They can't do any of that shit. They're not getting money.
Freedoms?
And then when they get caught, like... getting money from boosters or whoever the fuck, like the coach gives them some money, they're in trouble. Like, they need to eat. You know what I mean? Like, they're not getting free food on the scholarship. The scholarship only covers so much. It's education. They can't do much with that in terms of staying alive.
But not just that, just the fact that, like, these A lot of these kids that they get are from the inner city. Let's be real. Yeah,
no, and they are.
What do you expect someone who's lived their entire life, hey, let's survive day to day, for them not to do something a little shady to, like, and you're shocked?
Yeah.
No need.
That's why you never see offensive linemen getting in trouble. They're all fat white guys from Idaho.
Like, we're just happy to be here.
Or, like, some weird part of Michigan. Like, yeah, we're... Money? What's...
My parents have
My house has a lake. We're fine. I still live with... I have enough money to drive the hour away to school to live with my parents still. That's rich. But yeah, like, those inner city athletes, like, they're super talented and they're just poor. And they go to school poor. There's not much, like, after the scholarship money, unless you, you know, you don't go full-time. Yeah. You know, and you get that money back. Like, that's your money, but you're not going full-time and you're going to be in school longer.
Yep.
There's, other than that, you can't do anything. Because the off-season for football, all you're doing is training. You're basically just working out, unless you're playing another sport.
Yep. And then you're usually training.
A lot of football players play baseball in college, too, just to keep in shape. And they're super good at it, but they're not, like, major league, you know, prospects. They're just good at baseball, too.
Yeah.
And they're going to do that because they can walk on easily. But yeah, the whole setup of NCAA and college athletes is bullshit.
Yeah.
Give them something. You guys are fucking loaded.
Because they're
loaded.
They're just exploiting them.
That's what they're doing. Yeah, exactly. And they are completely, like, they are loaded.
Like, it's so funny. We talked about it earlier. We talked about it a couple podcasts ago. I was at a Royals game. Mm-hmm. I saw a guy with a Florida jersey on that had number 15 on it.
Yeah.
I immediately thought.
Can't put the name on the back.
Tim Tebow.
Yeah. Remember when.
He should be making money off that.
Remember, like, when MU had Brad Smith?
Yeah.
All those number 10s.
Yeah.
JCPenney, fucking Sears, Walmart, everywhere. Never had a B. Smith on the back.
No. Can't do it. But you knew who he was.
Exactly.
And who was also getting some money from it?
MU.
MU.
Because they had their emblem on there and the name.
Yep.
It's bullshit. I hate it. They are basically professional athletes. You know,
if you're at the D1 level, yeah.
For all intents and purposes.
If you're at the D1 level, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, if you play at fucking, you know, like, Pacific University. If you play golf at Pacific University, maybe don't expect, you know, the NCAA to pay you for doing that. And that poses a good argument, though. It's like, where do you draw the line? Like, at what point do you say... Well, okay, we can pay the Notre Dame guys, but we don't want to pay the North Dakota State guys.
Well, it'd be the same thing like
FCS.
It'd be the same thing like how the Royals have a different salary cap or have a different amount of money that they can spend on a team compared to the New York Yankees.
Yeah.
It'd be the same thing.
Well, and I think there needs to be some kind of sanction brought on for the NCAA where you give, you know... They don't need a lot of money. They don't need a ton. They just need enough because they're not going to pay for housing. They're not going to pay for, you know, travel. All they need is, like, food money. Yeah. And, like, their basic needs, like their cell phone, you know, all this other shit. Pretty sure the internet's free on most campuses. So give them $500 a month, NCAA. You can spare that. You're making buku fucking dollars. You are fucking rich. There's no reason why... You need all that money. What are you doing with it?
Doing the same thing, like, that Jim Paterno is doing with his team. Get those hookers.
It's not like they're building, you know, monuments or anything. Like, there's... Your entire business is collegiate athletics. You're not, you know, building new stadiums for colleges. Those colleges are building those, you know, stadiums for themselves. And that they make the money too, and it's just bullshit. Those people, those kids, you know, they're fucking 28, they're 18 years old, they're 19 years old, they're red-shirting on, you know, at Notre Dame, and they can't eat. It sucks. It's terrible. It's an inhumane way to fucking treat somebody.
Yep.
And that's the Beer and Friendship Show.
Fuck
the NCAA, you're the worst.
So, Aaron...
What's up?
We've reached another end of another podcast.
We did it. We did a podcast.
I'm guessing you probably have some plugs.
I have a few, a handful of plugs, I think. A disfigured handful of plugs. November 3rd, I will be in St. Louis. I think that's a Tuesday.
Can I come?
If you want. I don't care. It'd be great. I'm spending the night, though.
Fine.
Yeah, perfect. I think it's at the... What's it called? I don't know. It's my friend... it's my friend's birthday down there. He's having a show, so he wanted me on. Which is cool.
I'm going to open up for you.
You want to? There's like 10 other people on the show, though. It'll be a crowded show.
Hey!
Hello, everybody! No, it's... and then... Like I said earlier, November 13th, I'm in Lawrence at the Jazz House. I think November 11th, I'm opening for a guy named Derek Sheen at the Tank Room, downtown Kansas City. And then November 28th, I'm back in St. Louis for another show. We're doing with some Beer and Friendship alums, Scott Schaefer and... Tom. Tom.
Alright. Is that all?
I think so. There's probably some other shit, but forget.
As always, like, subscribe, listen to our podcast. If you want to make memes.
Come over.
If you want to make memes, if you want to make things, if you want to ask us questions, please
do. If you want to send us money for food,
that could be good too.
Because the NCAA sanctions how much money we make.
Yeah, they actually sanction. Like, they came to us and they're like, hey, guys.
You gotta stop. This is illegal.
You guys are making too much money.
Apparently the NCAA is Tina Turner.
So.
What's love got to do?
And you know what? It might be 50 Cent pretty soon, too. So who knows?
I think he's doing all right.
He's got that vitamin water, right?
Pump that bitch up.
All right. Well, guys, thank you so much. Live, laugh, love.
Goodbye. Kevin loves all of you.
Big kisses.
Kevin McClintock. What's your name? Oh, he's gone.
All right. We'll talk to you guys next week.
Bye-bye.
We're going to drink all the rest of this beer. Bye. I can hear Aaron pissing on the microphone.